Hello friends, let's continue getting acquainted with new Zigbee network coordinators based on the CC2652P7 module, which is more powerful compared to the P2 version. We'll discuss the Ukrainian development SMLIGHT SLZB-06P7 and compare it with the previously reviewed coordinator of the ZigStar project, UZG-01. In addition, I'll talk about some aspects of firmware for Zigbee modules by the author of Zigbee 2MQTT, current as of the version released on May 7, 2023. In the description, I will leave several links to my previous reviews, in which I talk about replacing the USB coordinator without reconnecting devices, installing a second Zigbee 2MQTT, and using Zigbee 2MQTT and Zchase simultaneously, all of which are also relevant for this device. So I will not dwell on these points in detail to avoid repetition. Before we start, as usual, I ask you to like this video so that more people interested in smart home topics can find it, and subscribe to my channel if you haven't done so before. Device type, Zigbee, LAN, USB, Wi-Fi gateway. Control modules, ESP32, LAN 8720, CP2102. Zigbee module, CC2652P7. Power supply, USB-C or power over Ethernet 802.3AF. Maximum number of connected devices, up to 300. Operating modes, Zigbee to Ethernet, Zigbee to Wi-Fi, Zigbee to USB. Switching via the web interface or a button on the case. Network functions, Zigbee coordinator or router. Firmware update for the device and Zigbee module via web interface in semi-automatic mode without the need for additional software. Size, 160x22x24mm. The device comes in a beautifully designed black box featuring the manufacturer's brand design. It mentions support in Zigbee 2MQTT, Zchase, and the operating modes. On the other side, it lists brief technical specifications that I've already mentioned, the package contents, and the official contacts. The device is developed in Ukraine. The packaging is well thought out. Those who have seen my review of the version on the CC2652P2 module have already seen similar packaging. In this regard, nothing has changed. The package includes a coordinator, a detachable antenna, a template ruler useful for marking holes, an adapter for USB-C port, mounting hardware, two screws and two pieces of double-sided tape, and an Allen key. Externally, the review hero does not differ from the P2 module version I mentioned, so you can only tell them apart by the sticker on one side. Additionally, the P2 version comes in a blue box, but otherwise, the design has not changed. Why change something that is already successful and recognizable? As I mentioned, I will be comparing it with the new ZigStar UZG-01 coordinator, built on the same Zigbee module. They have many similar features, but, as you can see, design is not one of them. ZigStar is made in the form of a square box. By the way, its Chinese clone Hamgeek is also square. I will leave a link to the Hamgeek review on CC2652P2 in the description. Meanwhile, SMLIGHT is designed as a long stick. Which of these is more convenient depends on where you plan to place the device. Disassembling the coordinator is quite simple. You need to remove the bottom cover from the latches and carefully extract the board from the case. I remind you, the ZigStar case is held by a couple of screws, but overall, it is also easy to disassemble. Apart from the shape, the differences in construction include that in the SMLIGHT, everything is soldered directly onto the main board, whereas the ZigStar uses external modules. The Zigbee module, CC2652P7. The connector for connecting an external antenna is soldered directly onto the board. The same module in ZigStar. Here, the antenna connector is connected via a short cable segment. The control module based on ESP32, also soldered directly onto the board, and on the other side of the same board, an internal antenna is placed. ESP32 module with an internal antenna at ZigStar. Both coordinators can be powered either through USB-C or PD. This is the power section of SMLIGHT. And this is ZigStar. For connecting and powering both devices, I use a budget 10-to switch. Its feature is that it also receives power in the same way, through the network port. The other four ports are used to connect other devices. In my case, ZigStar and SMLIGHT are operational. As a power source, I used a UPS, which not only adds 48 volts to the regular network coming to it from the router, but also provides autonomy of operation. I also leave a link to the review in the description under the video. Thus, both the switch and all devices connected to it will work during a power outage, and moreover, the UPS can power the router and server, completely taking over the entire smart home control center. Let's move on to the interface. Since my review of the P2 version, it has significantly changed, and for the better. Here's the main page, where you can see it's the P7 model, with information on the firmware versions for Zigbee and ESP32. For comparison, here is the current interface of the P2, which I use in my working system. The differences are only in the versions, and the fact that it is currently connected to 3 servers. This is the interface of the ZigStar UZG-01. Its design is very similar to the previous version of the SMLIGHT design, different from the current one, as you can see. But in terms of content, there are still many similarities. The main page with basic information and firmware versions. The SMLIGHT modes page, by default, Zigbee to Ethernet is enabled, which I believe is most optimal for such a coordinator. The same page for ZigStar, which also displays LED control. Next is the network settings page, starting with wired. By default, the mode for automatically obtaining an address from the router is enabled, but it can be switched to manual mode. In the ZigStar interface, functionally it's the same, only the settings are divided into 2 pages. This is for Ethernet. In SMLIGHT, everything is on one page. To configure Wi-Fi, you just need to scroll down. In ZigStar, switch to the next. As I've said, I believe the optimal mode is through a wired connection, Wi-Fi only in extreme cases. These are the settings for control systems that can be simply copied. For Zigbee 2 MQTT, for Zche, with which the device also works, moreover, it can be installed simultaneously with Zigbee 2 MQTT, you'll find the link to the tutorial in the description. And separately for the USB operation mode. In ZigStar, similarly, there are separate settings for each of these modes. The differences are only visual, in the arrangement of elements on the page. Functionally, there are no differences. Security settings. Here are 3 options: disabling the web server when connecting a client, which will not allow settings to be changed while the system is running, enabling password authentication, and setting a whitelist of addresses. All the same is available in the corresponding tab on ZigStar. Now, the differences begin. In SMLIGHT, a VPN option has appeared, providing secure remote connection to the home assistant server, for example, in cases where they are geographically located in different places. ZigStar doesn't have this. It has the option of connecting via MQTT. To activate it, you need to enter the mosquito broker data, address, port, login, and password. There is a discovery option for automatic detection in Home Assistant. This involves transferring data about the coordinator and the ability to control some of its options directly from Home Assistant. In some cases, the ability to reboot the Zigbee or ESP32 module might come in handy. The next tab is Settings and Tools. On the first, you can set the network name of the device. There are 4 buttons for rebooting Zigbee and ESP32 modules, enabling firmware mode, and reconnection. In ZigStar, it's the same, but control of the operation mode and LEDs is also duplicated here. Let's briefly skip the firmware update tab. We will return to it shortly. Next is the LED management page, including automatic off during nighttime, time zone settings, and time synchronization servers, in the system log. In ZigStar, there's only one tab, excluding the previously discussed and firmware updates. It contains the console and file manager. Firmware updates. In SMLIGHT, through the web interface, it's possible to check and update both the firmware of the control module, including installing your firmware in the Zigbee module. Here's what the firmware menu for the ESP32 looks like. You can choose not just the latest version, but also previous versions. The current version at the time of testing was 2.0.18. Out of the box, it was installed with 2.0.16. Here's what the update looks like. It's very convenient and quick, directly from the web interface. For comparison, firmware versions for SMLIGHT on the P2 version. There are no differences in versions, which is logical, the control module is the same. In ZigStar, at the moment, only the control module can be updated. Zigbee is still under development. The current version at the time of testing was 0.2.0, much lower than SMLIGHT's, but it also appeared much later. Here's the Zigbee module update option in SMLIGHT, and ZigStar does not have an equivalent yet. From the user's perspective, this is a key difference. For the P7 version, there are 2 firmware versions available, 2023-0507, the current official from the Zigbee 2 MQTT author, which I'll discuss in more detail, and 2024-0301. A modification for SMLIGHT. Since the firmware number is nothing other than its release date, it was released very recently. Firmware, just like ESP32, is directly in the web interface. If you have Zigbee 2 MQTT or ZCHE connected to the coordinator, you must stop them before updating. For comparison, firmware for the P2 model. Here, versions correspond to the official Zigbee 2 MQTT site, but I have installed not the latest version but the previous one, from December 2022, and soon I'll explain why. This is the current page of firmware on the Zigbee 2 MQTT GitHub as of the date of this video. I've highlighted the version used for the P7 coordinators. For updating, it's convenient to use a special add-in for Home Assistant or the ZigStar GW Multitool application, and you'll find links to video tutorials in the description below the video. The add-in is more convenient because you don't need to manually upload the firmware file. You just have to specify it on the settings page before starting. Now about the 2023-0507 firmware, which is current as of the release of this video. It has a problem that manifests on some networks. This issue is that every few hours, or even days, data exchange with devices on the network stops. It's like it freezes. And this occurs on various coordinators, P2, P7 versions, on ZigStar, HamGeek, SMLIGHT. This is a firmware issue, its author is aware of it, and has been searching for a solution all this time. The history can be found on the project's GitHub. From what I understand, a solution is possible but depends on the chip manufacturer. In the case of coordinators on the P2 version, the solution is to use the previous version of the firmware, released in December 2022. But for P7, this firmware is the only one, except for the SMLIGHT modification, which, as far as I know, does not globally solve the problem, but it still needs to be verified. Therefore, if you are planning to buy such a coordinator to replace an existing one, you should not rush to transfer all your devices to it immediately, as shown in the ZigStar UZG-01 review. It would be wiser to set up a second instance of Zigbee 2 MQTT and gradually, one by one, transfer your devices to it, observing each for some time to identify if any of them cause the network to stop. You'll also find a link to a video tutorial on installing a second Zigbee 2 MQTT in the description. To conclude the comparison, I will show the option to change the interface language for SMLIGHT. Currently, ZigStar does not have this feature. The device information page includes links to the manual, the official website, and contacts. A similar page for ZigStar, but from there, you can also download the latest firmware version. How do I plan to use this coordinator personally? In my current working configuration, I use 3 control servers, each connected to 2 Zigbee coordinators, SMLIGHT SLZB-06 version P2 and ZigStar LilyZig, also with CC2652P2. I added a third Zigbee 2 MQTT repository. For this, remember, you need to modify the path to it, but in such a way that it leads to the same place. Specifically, I removed the letter S from HTTPS and added a slash at the end. This way, another instance of Zigbee 2 MQTT appears in the add-on store. I showed this in more detail in my video tutorial, which you can also find in the description. Next, I'll remind you of the main points. To install the add-in, you need to specify a path to a new folder. This is done before its launch. Change the network port. I simply take the next ones after the standard. In the folder specified in the add-in configuration, we create a configuration template, available in text form in the description of my video tutorial. After that, I launch it. When using it on multiple servers, after Zigbee 2 MQTT starts on the first one, you need to copy the generated PAN ID and network key from the configuration and use them. Now I have 3 Zigbee 2 MQTT instances. Even though I installed the firmware version from March 1st, 2024, in Zigbee 2 MQTT, it still appears as the May version. I assume this is because it's simply a refined official firmware. In the SMLIGHT interface, it now shows 3 connections, corresponding to the number of my servers. And here's why I connected it. I will be removing devices from the networks on the P2 coordinators and connecting them to the P7 coordinator. But only 1 or 2 devices every few days. There's no rush here. I'll be monitoring the network behavior. If, over several days, it doesn't freeze at all, then it'll be safe to move the next device. This way, I might be able to identify devices that cause crashes. From a system operation perspective, it's sufficient to restore all settings and object names for all automations to continue working. So, functionally, the SMLIGHT SLZB-06P7 and ZigStar UZG-01 are identical devices. They use the same Zigbee modules, and control is implemented on ESP32. Both can operate over a network, wired or Wi-Fi, and through USB. Power can be supplied via USB or PoE. The differences I see are only at the firmware level. The version for SMLIGHT is more advanced, which makes sense as it was developed much earlier than ZigStar. The version for ZigStar is currently at the initial version's level of SMLIGHT. The most significant difference, in my opinion, is the ability to update the Zigbee firmware from the web interface. When the firmware for ZigStar acquires similar capabilities, I believe the difference between the devices will become virtually unnoticed. That's all. I hope this video was useful and interesting to you. I would be grateful for your likes. They help promote it on YouTube. If you don't want to miss new reviews and lessons, subscribe to my channel. In the video description, I will leave all the necessary links to stores where you can buy this device, to other reviews and lessons I mentioned. There you will also find links to my Telegram channel, now available in 2 languages, my Facebook page, and a group for discussing smart home issues. Join us, it will be interesting. Thank you for your attention. Until next time, peace to all.